Have you seen UpstateAllStarsTV.com? They are the authority for the hottest hip-hop, rap, R&B, dancehall artists in upstate New York and worldwide. Check out interviews, documentaries, and banging music 24/7. You can also watch UpstateAllStarsTV.com at home on your big screen by way of your Fire Stick, Xbox, or PlayStation Internet browser. The real dopest artist on the planet is playing right now on UpstateAllStarsTV.com. Also, make sure you follow them on Twitter at Upstate All Stars and on Instagram at The Upstate All Stars. I'll leave the link right at the top line of the description box. Go check them out right now. UpstateAllStarsTV.com. Tell them Old God from Hip Hop News Uncensored sent you. Ready, set, go.
Shout out to Kev. And Kev was also, I don't know if you've seen this, Old God, transition a little bit, but stay on Kevin Hart.
Yeah.
He was on Twitter today. He said he had some time today, and he addressed the issue that a lot of people talk about, man. We talked about on this platform numerous times, and it's the Is Kevin Hart Funny conversation.
Oh, shit.
And this is what Kev said on Twitter. He said that he's not funny slander is the best. This is for you. I have 3 stand-up comedy specials that fall in the top 10 highest grossing comedy specials of all time. 2 of my specials are in the top 3 of all time. I've been the highest grossing comedian in entertainment for years now. I have also been the highest grossing comedian in the box office with over $4 billion in earnings. I've also turned my comedic talent into a place of business and branding and radio and other revenue streams. The hate slander fuels me to do more. You guys are what makes this business fun because it's not about getting to the top. It's about doing your best to stay on top after you get there. I rarely talk shit, but I felt the need today. Stop believing these headlines and read the actual articles. You guys fall for the banana in the tailpipe trick every damn time. J. Cole said it best. If you're laughing at a millionaire, the joke is on you. Now back to your regularly scheduled program. Love, live, and laugh. Kevin Hart, what you think?
You got, so you got the people out there. And you at the same time, we'll have a comedian come on here. You know what I mean? That'll tell you, like, it ain't all about the numbers. And it ain't all about, you know, the money and things like that. And the numbers you did and all that. Like, just like when you got the best... You know, the person who sells the best, the rapper that sells the most albums ain't necessarily always the best.
Right.
So I get that. Like, salute Kevin for his accolades and all that. It's fucking unprecedented, like, what he did, you know, as a comedian, you know, to do what he did. We clap for you, salute you, bow to you, whatever you want. But at the end of the day, the critics have a point when they say that, I ain't gonna say that he's not fun to me. He ain't that funny, dog. I'm gonna be honest with you. I told you that before.
Said that day one,
you know what I'm saying? Like, he just ain't that funny as people. And a lot of people don't make me laugh. So if you can make me laugh, that's a great thing. But you can't ignore the people who see what they see. Like, somebody see what they see. That's their experience. They're like, dog, okay, some people saying this dude wore himself down over the years. But, Sam, man, you've been following him way longer than I've been following him. So what's your thoughts on this?
I think everybody has a right to their opinion. And you can't get mad at everybody that doesn't like you. Not everybody's going to like you. Not everybody's going to think you're funny. But there's a level of respect that still has to be given to somebody's hard work. And I can always appreciate from you the fact that you've always stood on that sword and said you've never thought Kev was funny. But you've never downed a brother to where you don't want to see him successful, make money, and do his thing. Mm-hmm. And that's what we got to be at. We can always agree to disagree, but we always got to have each other's best interest at heart if they ain't doing nothing fucking bad or nothing terrible to you, even though you may not like where they're coming from. Kevin Hart was funny as shit to me coming in. I fuck with his movies. I fuck with his stand-up. I couldn't wait for him to blow up. He blew up. And now the money he's making and I guess the people that he has riding on him, there's certain places he can't go anymore or do. I wish he could because a lot of the stand-ups that made some of those crazy amounts of money that it made to me as a fan of Kevin Hart still and always will be weren't as funny as the old ones. And I think we had Lavelle Crawford on. I think it was Lavelle.
Yeah.
Who made a great point when he said, you can't, when you start getting successful and you start talking about billionaire and millionaire, and you're in private jets, that shit ain't as funny as it was when you were struggling.
Damn.
And when Kevin Hart is at the top of his career, it ain't as funny about talking about Kev the Bastard when his dad was in school with no draws on talking shit. It ain't as funny. It ain't as relatable because we ain't sitting in the $1 million mansions and cribs. So hearing that from an OG kind of gives you perspective as well, man.
It's a difference between popularity and being funny. Period. You know what I mean? At the end of the day.
That's a good point because I remember, I forgot where we were about to go, but I was in my old crib and I had the Cat Williams joint on. And that motherfucker had a scream.
Yeah.
Screaming. And Cat Williams has had, and I'm not comparing these two brothers because obviously they've been compared for a long time, but I think if Cat Williams came back, the motherfucker would be just as funny as it was the last time.
Oh, yeah. He just, some people just got that it factor.
And he don't care either. He don't, right. He's not worried about saying something to piss somebody off. And I think that freedom is what makes it even funnier.
And then, yeah, and then you know, there was even, I guess the cancel culture thing came up about Kev, and he was kind of responding to that, and he was pretty much saying, I've been canceled 3 or 4 times already. You know what I mean? At this point, like, when I'm going to really be canceled. But it's just like, you know, you just got to, you know, just keep your head above water and keep doing what you do as a comedian, because the criticism is definitely going to come. You know what I mean? No matter, you know, who you are. But Cat Williams, Kevin Hart, I mean, you said it, Sam, man. Once you're afraid to offend certain people, you know, he got the backlash from the Oscar thing and all that. And, you know, you say something to offend this group or that group and that group, and now they start messing with your sponsors and shit like that.
It's a lot.
You're going to pull back. But we don't give a damn, like some people. And it is what it is. Yeah, you're going to have the comments. You may lose a couple of this, but it ain't all about money for everybody. It's a good thing to have. You can take care of your family and all that. Everybody's not worried about losing money or sponsors. I'm sure, you know, Cat Williams and people who really towed the line have lost a lot of stuff, but you get it back in the future. So it's something to say to be somebody, you know, somebody who can to come out there raw and don't give a fuck, and somebody who does. It's going to be a different level, and I think that's what we see with Kevin Hart. But then again, I don't want to take nothing away from the dude, because the dude is a master. He's a genius. We saw who's after the dude Crockett, whatever. He's going back and forth. He still got it.
Yep.
But when are you going to use it? Show us that you got it and use it, you know, in the arenas and not just on Instagram Live.
Yeah, he damn sure got it. But I don't know if he got that gun on safety. He got it on the safety. And I ain't mad at him. Do your thing, Kev. Whatever's going to feed your family, you're like, we ain't in your house. We damn sure ain't paying your bills. Do what you got to do. But on the other hand, respect people's honest opinions and don't always get so defensive to people who do care and do ride with you if they don't, in fact, agree with you all the time.
I got a question for you. If, because I think, I forget who it was talking about that the Kings of Comedy should have kept going and evolving it, you know. Do you think right now if we were to do another Kings of Comedy, even the Queens, but talking about Kings as an example, that Kevin Hart would be among that group of people right now? If we had to put a special up, like, all right, Kings of Comedy, we got Cedric, Steve Harvey, Cat, whoever.
Right.
Is Kevin in that?
If he comes with it. He has to come with it. Because now you're on the stage. And we remember the Kings of Comedy back in the day. Steve Harvey came out and did his thing. He was funny. Then DL came and did his thing. Then Cedric brought home Bernie. And they all had to bring it because they know Bernie was bringing that smoke.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you would have to come bring that smoke. We couldn't get that Kevin Hart talking about the mansions and shit. You got to go in on the Bill Maher's and rip them to fucking shreds.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
On the haters and rip them to fucking shreds. And do just, there's ways and levels you can go about this shit still be funny. Because I think as just a genuine dude, me being around him smoking and laughing and chilling, like, he would make me laugh. He's a funny dude to me. So, but doing that shit and the punchlines and the jokes trying to appease another level of audience, you would have to come with it, brother. With that being said, yeah, if he came with it, yes. If not, it ain't in his best interest to even fuck with it.
But he's capable of it, you're saying?
Absolutely.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with that.
Absolutely.
Definitely. That'd be crazy, man, if they did another King Comedies right now. Like, just imagine, like, the names you would have to, like, put in there. People, even people that wouldn't make it. Like, the rejected list could be like the show or something. Like, the people who didn't make the cut is still funny. There's so many great comedians, yo.
You could make that a 2-hour show where you had a pre-show with Young Bulls, comedians, hungry people doing their thing, mixed music in there, and then had a real show with them doing their 20-minute sets. That shit would be fucking...
Is TK in it?
And TK in it. Fuck.
He's a beast, though.
TK definitely deserves a spot on that show somewhere.
Maybe he could be the host.
Yeah, something like that. He definitely deserves a spot on there where he could talk his shit, because he's funny as hell. He can go in for hours.
Watch this shit happen. Somebody gonna hear this shit and do this shit in like the next 2 years, and we should say we could have done that shit.
Yeah, hell yeah. Hey, y'all already know who to hit. Maybe we might set some shit like that up out here.
That'd be crazy.
That'd be crazy.
Woo!
You know what I'm saying?
Make this shit to a DVD. Not DVD.
The niggas don't like the old ass nigga watching this shit no more. I remember when I had my fucking, we had the mixtape, and I was talking to my old boy Pook, and I was like, yeah, you want to buy my mixtape? This was fucking 2016. He laughed at me like, nigga, ain't nobody buying CDs.
Oh, damn.
This is on the stream, old ass motherfuckers.
Right?
Damn.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a product that can't move shit.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, salute to Kev, man. Don't promoting this movie. We got Fatherhood coming out soon, man. So we are always here around promotion time. Kev doing his thing, man.
Yeah, shout out to him, man. Definitely shout out to him. But yeah, man. That's all we're going to do today here, man. It's not too much going on, but we definitely want to come here and cover these couple of topics for you guys today. And if you're listening on YouTube, man, make sure you guys, you know, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and always select the option that says get all notifications. Double check real quick to make sure you've done that. If you're listening on the podcast, you already know, man, leave a comment, leave that 5-star rating, and make sure you you know, share this joint with somebody, man. We definitely appreciate all the day ones, all the people that have been defending us, you know what I mean, and rocking out with us and standing with us through thick and thin. We see you and we appreciate it.
Indeed. Peace.